$7,890. That is the amount of money that I lost after a crazy, irresponsible idea I had to throw a party last Friday. Let's start at the beginning.
My name's Andrew, and for as long as I can remember, I've always loved throwing parties. I do an annual Christmas party, I organize what my friends do for New Year's every year, and I am a master at convincing my friends who don't want to go out into tearing up a dance floor.
Yo, what are you doing tonight?
Hey, dude, I'm probably gonna stay in. I don't know, take it easy.
We are having some people over if you want to come and drink.
I got my car, so like I could maybe drive over.
Okay, wait, no, don't bring your car.
What? Oh.
Just come over, and we'll have a few drinks. And we'll just see where it goes.
All right, I'll do it.
But now I want to do something different. I want to rent out a venue, hire staff, sell tickets and alcohol, and legally throw a party better than anything you'd find at a club or bar. Only problem is, I don't even know where to start. Which leads me to step one, the alcohol permit.
I live in Toronto, Canada. I don't know what the laws are anywhere else, but here, if you want to do what we're doing, you need to get something called a public event special occasions permit. And to obtain one of these, you need to either have a charity or a not-for-profit company. So, looks like I'm starting a nonprofit.
It looks like to start a nonprofit, you need a company name, address, and three directors. So, I'm one. Nonprofit, here we come. The name we came up with was Bench Social Club. Because every event with us is a and it's a bench. An adventure. It sounded better on paper. Anyway, we got our registration in the mail. We set up a bank account and we bought an alcohol permit for May 4th. It was about a month and a half from when we first bought it, and we figured that was enough time to get everything else together. And if everything went smoothly, we would have been right. But we'll get to that part later.
Next on our list is to find a venue. A venue is the most important part of the whole thing.
It's gotta be in a good location and be big enough to hold a lot of people. The more people we can sell tickets to, the more profitable the event can be, and I really don't wanna lose money on this. Our venue search started off a little rough.
There, go back.
Oh, okay, one sec, let me go.
All right, I'm gonna get out.
Okay.
I got it.
We found hundreds of those signs all around Toronto, and we've been calling all of them, but most of them have been going pretty much like this.
Hi, sorry, quick question. Do you guys ever do single night leases?
No.
We don't have time to focus 100% of our attention just on finding a venue, so we're gonna keep making calls, but we have to start looking at other aspects of the event. Starting with our top concern, staff.
If we're gonna sell alcohol, we need bartenders. This is actually probably the easiest part of the staffing process, only because Chris is a musician, and as one, he's played all over downtown, bars, clubs, etc., and he knows bar staff. He actually reached out to a couple guys a few weeks ago and already secured us two bartenders for the night. So, one down. Safety is a huge priority of ours, and our band legally can't run without hiring security guards to staff it. We don't have any leads or connections here, so I literally just took to Google, and I think I found a security company that might be able to help us. Let's give them a call. Hi, my name's Andrew. I'm looking to hire some security for an event I'm putting together on May 4th. It's Bench Social Club. It's like the word bench, but with a V.
No, you have a stupid name. I'm just getting the call I did like 2 minutes ago. But good news is, they're in, we got four security guards.
The last important job that we need someone for is the DJ. If we want people to actually get up and dance on our dance floor, we need the right person who knows how to hit our demo. But lucky for us, I'm here to get the best DJ that this city
has. No, man, we already got one.
What do you mean we?
Yeah, we got one.
You both came together and got a DJ. And didn't think we should tell it. What kind of music's he gonna play?
Yeah, you know, like classic throwbacks.
Top 40s.
Basic girl stuff.
Perfect.
So we just got a call back from a venue, and it's a pretty cool location. It's a woman's gym, central downtown, close to the subway station, and we can actually afford it. Most importantly, it's pretty big.
It's two massive rooms connected by a lobby area that we could use as the bar, adding up to about 4,000 square feet. And we figure we can fit probably 250, 300 people in there. And now that we have a number, we can start selling tickets. We wanted to try two different ways to sell tickets. Number one was to run ads on Instagram. Only problem is, we don't have any past event footage to use, so we had to get creative. I didn't set the expectation too high there, right? And the final way is just convince people the old-fashioned way. So we printed out 500 of these flyers, and I've just been canvassing university campuses, telling people how dope the party's gonna be. Excuse me. So we're hoping, between both methods, that we could fill this place up. The next problem that we have on our plate is alcohol. If somehow we manage to actually fill the whole venue up, we've calculated we're gonna need just over $2,000 worth of alcohol. I know, guys. We've talked about this. To make it cheaper, we were hoping we could find a sponsor.
So we sent out a few emails, and we just heard back from a huge local brewery called Steam Whistle, and they invited us down for a visit.
We just got ourselves an alcohol sponsor.
And then for everything else, we made a trip to the liquor store. A very, very, very big trip.
Tell me what it is one more time.
$995.25.
And now that all that's done, all that's left is the little stuff. We rented tables, bought cups, coat hangers, sodas, water bottles, and now that we have all that, we're ready for event day.
Breaking news tonight, severe weather pounding parts of this province.
Winds were gusting up to 110 kilometers an hour in some areas.
The strongest wind in 54 years.
68,000 people were left without power.
It goes without saying that stay indoors unless you have to go out.
Okay. I just got to the venue, and there is a citywide power outage. The winds around the city are just crazy, like lights are being blown off, like signs are being pushed down. So there's no power here. There is a very real chance that this event might not happen, but we have to set up like it will anyway. So here's where we put all of our stuff, and we're just gonna start unpacking it, setting up, and hopefully having an event.
What if we don't get the power back?
No. It needs to be a full DJ setup. That's the one thing I can't compromise on. We need everything to be. So we still don't have power. The event starts in 40 minutes. I'm trying not to freak out. We're still trying to find a solution. They did say that they were sending a guy to come fix this. I don't know when he's gonna be here. Maybe we start the event late. I don't know. But we're keeping our heads high so far. Security just showed up. We're paying them. Hopefully there's an event to pay them for. Hey, welcome to our blacked out venue. We're making the most of the situation. We're here is going to be the DJ area and the dance floor area. This is in a phenomenal area. Super downtown, tons of people walking around. One more room over here. This is what makes us unique in my opinion. Our games room. So, a bunch of nice tables here, sit, have a little chat with your friends. Custom-made beer pong tables. I'm very excited about these. Giant Jenko over here. Chris and Emma, what are some props?
We're ready.
And those, of course, are for the photo booth. It's actually kind of nice, because no matter what, the photo booth doesn't get sacrificed. We can still make that run because it's on flash. Oh, and this is the bar. We have whiskey, tequila, rum, gin, Steam Whistle. Okay, I have a bit of an update. The DJ has two powerful Bluetooth speakers, so he's going to get them, he's gonna bring them back. But outside, it looks closed. We need lights also in the hall. We need some sort of lights in the hall.
We have lights up the stairs.
Okay, good. So we need to get people to know that this place is open. I'm gonna go out and hand flyers out, because I've been doing that for the last couple weeks. So hopefully people will pay cover and come in and not be disappointed. Come with me.
Hey, how's it going, ladies?
Good.
I have a quick question for you. There's gonna be like DJ, dance floor, the whole game. It's all set up right now. People think it's closed because the building has a power outage, but we have Bluetooth stuff.
I was gonna say, everything's on the street. Where is it?
I'll show you. Come with me.
Okay,
literally right here. These are our wonderful security. I think we might have just gotten two people right there. So that's a good start. I definitely just like pushed them into it. Hope they don't regret it.
The party is about 2 hours in. It's midnight right now. The turnout's okay. It's pretty good, actually. It's better than I would expect for it being a blackout. If the power came back, that'd be really nice. And I think this could be lit, because the club downstairs shut down, is not doing anything. So if the power came back, even if it doesn't, like, people are still coming here instead. Anyway, I gotta get back to it. I still don't know if we like made money or not. Like, I don't know how we did, but it's over. There's a lot of people here. It was a lot of fun, and I guess we have to unpack everything now. So we have a long night ahead of us, and then probably tomorrow we'll look at the money a little
more.
Yeah,
we'll figure it out.
Power going out, it hurt us, I'm sure, but at the end of the day, we made the best of it. We did what we could. I think it was really cool. A lot of our friends had a great time, so all it's left to do is clean up and see how we do tomorrow.
And sleep.
Coffee first.
Yes.
Which brings us to right now. Between myself and my two fellow directors, we spent almost 10 grand on the event. Even though there was a citywide power outage, we somehow managed to profit negative $3,300. Yeah, we did not profit anything. But it was never about the money. Originally, we arranged to give 80% of the profits to the Make-A-Wish Foundation, but because the event didn't turn a profit, we're gonna be donating $1,000 out of our own pockets because we want Venge to stand for something good. And even though we had a loss, I still see our party as a success. We had over 300 people walk through those doors, and all of the ones I've talked to not only loved it, but have been asking when's the next one. I honestly just wanted to throw a party that I knew all of my friends would like, because as great as Toronto is, the party scene is pretty stale, and we deserve better. I was not planning on throwing another party, but now I am. And this next one's gonna be bigger and better, as long as we have power.